My name is Marcel van Aken. I'm a professor in developmental psychology at Utrecht University in the Netherlands. And I've been a member of ISSBD since, I think, the mid-80s somewhere. And since 4 years, I'm the editor of the International Journal of Behavioral Development, which is the flagship journal of the Internet Society. Well, the basic aim is to publish papers on all kinds of developmental aspects all over the lifespan. So most of our papers are longitudinal studies, report on longitudinal studies. Not always, we also have cross-sectional data and so on, but it always, the focus is on the development, and especially the development over the entire lifespan. So not only childhood, not only adolescence, but also adulthood and older age. And that broad focus is the focus of the journal. And the development can be, it's behavioral development, but we also sometimes have paper that have more to do with biological development or with cognitive development, but always with a clear behavioral aspects in it. We would accept pure qualitative papers, yeah. So it's the focus of the journal is not on a specific methodology, although most of our papers are a quantitative analysis. But in principle, there would nothing be against a qualitative paper, or I think I would even prefer more mixed methods papers. So a combination of qualitative research and quantitative research, and these papers would be very welcome for the journal. Yeah. And the other papers, we do have a special section on methods and measures papers. So if someone has a paper that is really specific about a certain kind of method or a certain instrument or a certain approach, then we have a special section for that, and we're very interested in those kind of papers. They also in the meanwhile, this section is very relevant for the journal itself. We also publish review papers. So if someone writes a paper on a more integrative view on the field, for example, we publish those. We published, for example, a very nice paper on adoption studies last year, and that already is one of the most frequently cited papers from the journal. And sometimes we are interested in special issues or special sections. So if people have an idea that they would combine a number of papers, for example, a number of papers that were presented together on a workshop or together in a symposium, we would be interested in publishing them as a set. That's also possible. We have several instructions on our website, so an author should surely look at the website to see what a manuscript looks like. We now have a word limit of 6,000 words. We're not that strict about it, so if it's 7,000 words, we also accept it. But at least they should look at the website, what are the specific requirements for the journal. If an author has a little bit doubts about whether it would fit in a journal, he or she can also write me and, for example, send a manuscript all along so that I can have a first check of whether it would fit in the journal, or they can send an abstract or some ideas, and then I can comment on it and I can say, well, this could potentially be interesting for the journal, or I can already say, okay, so if it's on this topic, this is probably not what we will publish. But if someone has ideas or wants to talk about specific ideas with me, they're always welcome to mail me and we can talk about it. After you submit your paper, the first step is that I and one of my associate editors look at the paper to see whether we think it has a good chance in the end of getting published. sometimes we receive papers that are either on a given topic that we think, oh, so this is not the topic that we want to have, or they are simply not good enough, not of high enough quality, and we don't want to send them out for review because we almost already know how the review process is going to end, and that is not good for the author because he has to wait for 3 months and then receives a rejection. And it's also not good for the reviewers because they get to review papers of which they say, okay, you could have known from the start that this was not going to work. So we call that an early reject. And in that case, the author gets, within 1 or 2 weeks, gets a mail from me saying, we're not going to take this paper in review because, and then I give her several reasons why we think this paper will not make it. If we decide at that point that it could be a possible paper for IJBD, then we send it out for review to 3 or 4 reviewers most of the time. And we try to get the reviews back within 2 months. And that usually works most of the time. So then, if that case, if we send it out for review, the author receives a decision letter from the author within 3 months. And the decision letter, it almost never is immediately positive. Sometimes the decision letter is, okay, reviewers have looked at it, but there are so many problems with this manuscript that we cannot publish it. And then we give a list of all the problems so that the author can use it to improve the manuscript. And most of the time, an author gets a message saying, it's not good enough in the present version, but the reviewers have made a lot of remarks, and if you follow the remarks and try to change the manuscripts, then we can look at it again and it will have a higher chance of getting accepted. Yeah, so the issue of language is very important. We try to, in making the decisions on the papers, we try not to let language interfere. So we will never reject a paper because the English is not correct. Having said that, it's always good for an author to have a check of the English of the manuscript, because the difficulty is that if the English is not correct, then sometimes for a reviewer it is a little bit difficult to judge the merits of an article. So an author should always make sure that the English is as good as possible. But still, if it's not optimal English, then we do give an advice in that. So we could say we are willing to accept the article, but you really should have someone look at your English. We do not offer that ourselves. So we don't have a service that we improve the English, but we can point people to certain other people who could help with that. So, but it's not a service that the journal offers. But as said, it's not a really critical issue. A paper will never get rejected only because of the language. So. Well, one thing is, you have to realize this is part of the process. So I know even for very famous authors, papers get rejected. So everyone has to live with the experience that you submit a manuscript of which you think this was very good, and then you get reviews and they think it's not good enough. That's part of life of a scientist, so to say. And the other thing is that authors have to remember that reviewers really take their work seriously. That reviewers are not, it's not that they want to trash the work of an author. Every reviewer is very serious doing his job, and every reviewer is doing his best to look as serious as possible at the manuscript. And this also means that if you have a manuscript and it is rejected and it has 3 or 4 reviews, you should really carefully look at the reviews and see how you can use them to improve your manuscript. Maybe not for this journal, but for another journal or for another time. So you should, it happens that manuscripts get rejected, and the best thing you can do is learn from it. That's the best. Handling revisions is, as I said, you have to remember that if you get the decision of a revise and resubmit, that's actually quite good. It means that the reviewers and I, that we see possibility in your manuscripts. Only not the way it is now, but we do see possibility. Otherwise, we would not have suggested a revise and resubmit. Because what an author should do is really carefully look at the reviews and revise the manuscript according to all these comments. And if there is a comment and you think, oh no, this is not correct, I'm not going to do that, that's possible, but then you have to write a cover letter. So you submit a revised manuscript and you include also a cover letter in which you really say, from all the comments that were made of the reviewers, by the reviewers, you say, okay, so reviewer one said this and this, and we solved it by, and then you tell me what you have changed because of the comment of the reviewer. And if there's a comment in which you don't agree, you would say, so reviewer two says this and this, and then you could say, but we do not agree because that and that, and you can try to defend yourself. And then this manuscript and the cover letter goes back to the reviewers, and they then advise me, and they say, okay, so now we are convinced, or they say, no, the author did not do a good job in revising the manuscript, and then it can be possible that it still gets rejected. As I said, it's a process that works best if all the authors take their job seriously and submit only the manuscripts of which they really think this is good work, it needs to be submitted. The editor takes his job seriously and looks seriously at all the manuscripts that are submitted, because I have to realize that even if I think this manuscript is not so good, the author really thinks it's good enough to be submitted. And the reviewers have to be serious of their job. And if everyone takes their job seriously, then it's just a matter of time, and then the manuscripts will be accepted.